Hi, it's Peggy. I'm doing a Verre Eglomise glass piece. Already slumped it, put it in the kiln, sand carved it deep. This is half inch thick glass, and I've hand painted it literally with my fingers and oils. And I did a 14 karat gold inlay and overlay, which I'm working on now, and creating negative space. This is what it looks like, although the colors don't show up very well in this video. There's actually some very vibrant reds, greens, blues. But this is how I get the negative space after I've covered the whole piece of glass. I go in and I figure out where I want negative space. And then I very carefully take X-Actos with flat blades of different sizes. You can see that thin, thick, and razor blade scrapers. To go in, I've marked with an X on the other side, on the front side, where I want to remove the leaf. And I always like to have a little music in the background, but you can see here the negative space, the clear area. That gives it some more visual interest. But you got to be very, very careful when you do this. You don't want to scratch the glass, because if you scratch the glass, it's going to be magnified looking at through the top. And there's not really anything you can do about it. I mean, yeah, there's a couple of possibilities, but it's going to screw up the rest of everything. So I'm just very carefully going over the edges, which you can see here that I've got some areas where I have gone over the area, got past the circle. So I'm going to clean that up. And I'm using a medium blade right now to try and go over that. Because of the deep carving, it makes it easier to get off. You really cannot remove the leaf from the inlay that you've done in the carved areas, which are quite deep. They're about a quarter inch carved. And you just kind of very carefully go over it. And I take an emery board and we'll sharpen this a little bit or clean off the blade. And just very carefully. I hold it at an angle so that I'm not digging towards the glass. And it comes off and pieces, kind of rolls up, kind of gummy, sticky from the adhesive we used to put the leaf on. So this is the area I'm working on right now. And please excuse my choice of eclectic music. Although most of the stuff you'll find are Woodstock, Summer of Love era, and those musicians. I'm real known for blasting my music or putting the headphones on. Although in this new studio here in Carefree, that's open to the public, by the way, I'm a little more cautious with the stereo blaring. And just taking it very carefully. And bigger areas, I can use the razor blade scraper. These are just a paint scraper, but you got to make sure you don't get a neighboring area like this that you don't want to touch the leaf. It's almost impossible to just put the leaf in to the areas that you want leaf in, because the leaf is so thin, tears, blows away. It's just difficult. It's easier to cover the whole thing, get it inlaid and overlaid properly, and then just come in. You can put the sealer on and then come in and clean it up. I usually wait though for the sealer until after I get the excess leaf off. This is Verre Eglomise. It's about 400 years old, the process, not me or the glass. And I did not invent it. I learned the process from a wonderful artist, and then for the last 20 years that I've been doing this process, I've tried a lot of different things, added different techniques, materials, and the one thing you want to do is be very careful, because if you're going to sell your work, it's got to be first rate. Okay, let's see. A little more. I still got more to clean up in here, and some down here. And for whatever reason, the colors are not showing through on this video, but here you can see where I've got to clean all of this up. And some here. Okay, I'll show more once I get a little more done.